Alright, so we're going to remove the magnetron on this Ewave KOT15S. The same instructions apply to just about any microwave out there. Let's undo the screws holding everything together. So screw down here, screw up here. And there's a few on the back. It's gonna be one here, one there, one there, one there, and one there. You're gonna undo. So the part we're trying to replace is the magnetron, which is this item here. Thing to be careful of when you disconnect a microwave, especially after it's been freshly powered in, is the capacitor. You're going to want to discharge across the terminals with pliers or something just to short out that capacitor. Mine's been unplugged for a few days, so I'm not even concerned about it at the moment. So to get to this magnetron, you got to take off all this plastic. That's held on with a screw here. Underneath this part, we're going to undo a screw here. There's one down here, one somewhere on this. There it is. And I think, oh yeah, there's one at the back on the motor that we're going to disconnect as well. And there's one up here I forgot about. You'll want to disconnect that. Screw at the back on the fan motor. Once that's out, I should all lift it out. So we've got this part. That's all kind of does. You want to undo this clip here. Probably get away with hanging that off the side, but probably done, that'll be unscrewed right there and removed. Do it the shortcut way, unhook the fan, this thing. And then there's another connector. And there's another connector in here. Just kind of pull that off. This out of the way, you can access the four mounting bolts that hold your magnetron on. Take a careful look at the wiring, because when you disconnect this and this, and if you decide to replace the diode, is there your diode? Sometimes the diode will fail, you'll need to replace that. So just keep a track of where these wires go. It gets confusing when this wire might end up going here and this wire might end up going there. If you know where this is going, shouldn't be a problem. So what I got here is a 5/16 wrench. You're going to want to undo all four of these. Remember how this gets well laid out as well. I'm sure it doesn't matter, but it might. This insulated one was closest to you. This non-insulated one was furthest away from you. Undo that and then drop that main one out of there. On new Magnetron, sometimes it won't come with this. Just have to undo these two screws, stick it onto the new one in the exact same spot, and hook up the wire when you put it back in. Reassembly is reverse of this. Now when it comes to removing the diode on the capacitor, you want to access that screw right down there. We're going to undo that. That'll undo the strap, and all this capacitor will end up coming out. Out. And just unhook your diode, put in a new diode.